Hello and welcome to the Kubernetes talk series. So today in this video, we will see how to create the namespace with the multi-container pods. So let's get started. So here we have our cluster. So we can create a namespace with the two methods. First is by creating the YAML file, and another one is the imperative way, that is writing one single command. So let's first see how to create a namespace with the help of the YAML file. So I've already created one YAML file, which is ns.yaml. So here you can see the API version is v1, kind is namespace, and the name you need to specify, whatever name you need to give, I given namespace mp1. So let's apply this file and let's see what happens. So to apply this file, you can write kubectl apply minus f ns.yaml. So it will create one namespace mp1 for you. So we can also verify get ns by writing this command. So you can see it's created. Now the another way is, that is imperative way, by writing single command, which is kubectl create ns np, let's say give np2. So it's created. Now you can see the np2 namespace is created. You can also delete these namespaces. Let's say kubectl delete ns np2. So I want to delete the namespace np2. So we can give this and you can check again. So namespace is getting terminated. So again, if you write, see the namespace 2 is deleted. Similarly, you can delete namespace 1 by simply kubectl delete hyphen f ns.yaml. So it will delete the namespace 1. So let's check again. See if both the namespace has been deleted. Now let's see how to create a multi-container pod under the namespace. So I've already created one YAML file. So this is the YAML file. The API version is v1. Kind is pod. This is pretty much same like we did in the previous video, which we have created pod.yaml, where we have specified the Nginx image under the containers. It's as simple as that. The only difference here is we are adding another more container here, which is MySQL, and we are giving environmental variable. This is your choice. If you want to give the environment variable, then it's okay. If you don't want, then it's fine. So only difference here is we are specifying two containers. One is httpd, and another one is MySQL. So you can give any name for your container, TB or let's say web, okay? And here we are specifying the namespace multi. So let's apply this file and see what happens. So to apply this file, we will write kubectl apply minus f multi.yaml. So as you can see, we got an error, because the namespace multi is not present. So let's create the namespace. Kubectl create ns multi. So now namespace has been created. Now we will again apply the file. So now you can see multi-container pod has been created. We can check kubectl get pods. We need to specify the namespace also, so minus n multi. So the status is running here, and you can see two check is also ready. If you have two containers in your pod, they will be 2/2, and if you are having only one container, then you will be having 1/1. So that's how you create the multi-container pods in your under your namespace. And that's it for this video. And in the next video, we will see the services, how many services are available in our Kubernetes. Thank you.